juniors on the right side and juniors will sit on the right, this side right here, and seniors will sit on this side right here. This side. Juniors on this side, seniors on this side. Okay? All right. Any questions? Attention, if you're a parent or a relative here watching the assembly, can you please sit in this section over here, please? We're designating this section for family members. Right over here. Thank you.
She see money all around me.
Thank you. or not. When we go out, you'll be able to. Trust me. You'll just have to know what to do.
$25 for a single ticket and $45 for a couples ticket. Tickets will also be sold at the dance. And now for your prom court nominees. Up first, Jacob Bigley, escorted by his mother, Vicky Bigley, and father, Steve Bigley. Veronica Knudsen and grandmother Sharon Knudsen.
And I was like, why are you so obsessed with me?
Thank you.
is Colin Pagetti, escorted by his mother Jennifer Pagetti and father Ryan Pagetti. Now is McKenna Alfonso, escorted by her mother Jennifer Alfonso and father Kelly Alfonso.
I'm a September song, tell me where have you gone?
Roberto and Garcia. Julia Beeth, escorted by her mother, Mary Beeth, and
Armstrong, escorted by her grandparents, Barbara and Hank Pimentel.
Woo-hoo!
Jazz Band.
We want to remind everyone that prom is intended for junior and senior students. Please remember to be responsible, as prom night is a special night. The safety and health of our students is very important. You are all cherished individuals, and we want prom to be a night full of wonderful memories. Now, Mr. Vigil will recognize our spring sports.
Good morning. I want to say congrats, first of all, to the 2023 prom courts. You guys look amazing. Thanks to the Jazz Band one more time. Let's give them another round of applause. That was awesome. I want to thank the prom committee, student leadership, and Ms. Villapando for getting this this assembly set up and getting this week ready to go. And I know that's a tall task. But it turned out amazing, and tomorrow night's going to be amazing too. So let's give them a round of applause. Finally, let's give a nice warm welcome to our future Hornets next year, the eighth graders from Vineland, PV, Beulah, and some Connect students. Let's give them a round of applause. Okay, we're gonna honor some spring sports at this time and some activities that have taken place and finishing up for the year. So can I please have Ms. Gilman come on up and speak about speech?
Thank you, Ms. Faye.
Can I please have some senior baseball players come down and Coach Eads? Can I next have Esports seniors or juniors that we have for Esports, as well as Coach Grossen? What's up, all my hearted homies? This is the first year our school ever had an Esports program, and Republic County absolutely killed it. Esports, there are no divisions. We play Division 1, 2, 3, 4, Division 5 schools all over the state. Competition is fierce. We got 20 athletes that participated in the season, so I'll keep it short. Our Overwatch 2 team made it to playoffs. We ended the season ranked 26th overall, and that's extra impressive because Overwatch is unique. It's not just Colorado, it's the whole mountain time zone. So we got to play against Texans and Canadians, and we got to beat Texans and Canadians, which is awesome. Yes. Our Rocket League varsity made it to playoffs, ranked 21st in the state overall. League of Legends varsity made it to playoffs in the top 16, ended the season ranked 6th overall in the state. Super impressive. And finally, our Super Smash Brothers Ultimate teams had an excellent season. Both varsity A and B teams made it to playoffs. Last Friday, our season officially came to a close. Our A team traveled to Logan Host Gaming Center up in Denver to compete in the state championship, which was awesome. So really quickly, if I could have these three players stand, Jaden Casado, Aiden Tafoya, David Tafoya. Out of over 150 teams in the state, these guys are officially in the top 1% of all players. Right? It's very good. Thank you, Mr. Grossen. Next, can I have some senior representatives for girls golf and Coach Koshak?
Good morning, everybody. Congratulations to the court. You guys look amazing. You can always tell it's golf season when it's raining outside every day and miserably cold and super windy. All this spring sports kids picked up a lot. Our girls' ball team, we've had a really good year so far. We've been really successful. Can all my girls' ball guys go stand up? So we need that as well. We have a really large team, city-wise. I mean, we have 20 girls out on the team. Most teams only have like 5 to 10, so we have a very large team. We have a nice mix of new golfers and experienced golfers. We're about halfway through our season. May 22nd is our regional tournament. Our four regional ball players are going to be Samantha Hanson, Allie Woblick, Chris Lisak, and Kate Neal. So we wish them luck, and hopefully we can get a team to state and go win some races state. Thank you.
Thank you, Coach. Next, can I have some senior representatives from track and field? And Coach Soto.
So far with the season, it's been a pretty good season. We have a very strong girls team, a very young team, matter of fact, that's competing very well. Can I get all track athletes stand up? Freshmen and sophomores are very competitive, but led by some pretty good, solid upperclassmen. The way track season goes is you have qualifying meets throughout the year. You're only allowed so many, and at the end of the season, when the regular season ends, they take the top 18 event times, distance, throws, jumps, and so forth. And we have a few I'd like to mention that are very, very close to qualifying for the state tournament. Just gotta get that perfect run-in, perfect exchanges, throws, and so forth. On the boys' side, we have the 4x2, led by Ryan Ferris, Rayleigh Diaz-Gonzalez, Layden Morrows, and Tegan Dillon. On the 4x4, Wyatt Ferris, Brock Roseman, Sarah Vargas, and Tegan Dillon. And those are very, very close times there. On the girls' side, we have Kyla Rusich in the triple jump in the 100 hurdles. Delaney Pagetti in the 100 and 300 hurdles. Girls 4x2, Kyla Rusich, Zora Malone, Alyssa Peralta, Delaney Pagetti. And the 4x4, Zora Malone, Hope Musso, Maddie Smith, and Alyssa Peralta. Very close to reaching state qualifying times. We only have a few meets left, and tonight we have the SEL Championship, so it should be a fun night. Thank you.
Can I next please have some representatives from girls soccer, seniors? All right, man. Coach Thomas couldn't be here, but she just wanted to note a few things for these girls. First of all, can I have all girls soccer please stand up? So these girls are off to an amazing start as well. They're 9-1 right now. They're ranked eighth in 4A right now in the state. Coach said we have 47 goals combined. Pearson Weimer is in the top 25 of the entire state for goals scored, so let's give her a round of applause. We got a big match tonight against Centennial, and then we play Pueblo West this week as well. Next week we play Pueblo West. And then, so hopefully we get those two wins. We beat them once already, and then we'll have the SEL title and go on from there. So let's give them a round of applause. Can I please have some senior representatives from girls tennis? Do we have senior? There we go. All girls tennis players, please stand up. Give them a round of applause, please. Coach Tucker couldn't be here, but she said their season's going very well. They're currently 7-1 as a team, and they just beat Pueblo West this last week, which is always a good thing, so let's give that a round of applause, please. Girls tennis have currently 36 girls on the team, which is crazy. Regionals begin next week, and hopefully we can get all of our girls qualified for state. So best of luck, girls tennis. Can I please have any representatives for boys volleyball? Is there any representatives? Come on down. All right, guys. So boys volleyball is a co-op team, and it's based out of Pueblo South High School. And we have seven boys from County High School that play on that team. They're young, they're in a very, very tough league, and they're continuing to improve, and we wish them the best of luck on the remainder of the year. So let's give them a round of applause. Representatives for boys swim, come on down. Boys swim. Any seniors, juniors, anybody from boys swim? I know we got some. Nobody wants the cookies? Okay. Oh, there we go. All right. So boys swim is consisted of Pueblo West comes to us, and there's a lot of kids. We have a kid from Alamosa. We have some from Lamar, Lahana that come and swim for our team. Coach couldn't make it today, but he wanted me to say that the boys swimming season started strong in terms of returning swimmers as well as a talented group of new swimmers. They got a convincing win over the league opponent, Pueblo Central. They followed by a strong showing at the Cheyenne Mountain Invitational and back-to-back third place finishes at the Hornet and Fountain Fort Carson Invitationals. Currently have 8 swimmers qualified for state, and they're looking forward to a great state meet. So let's wish them the best of luck. Bear with me, I got a couple more. Can I have girls lacrosse? We got 5 girls. Can I have a representative for girls lacrosse? Come on down. So this is another co-op team. This is based out of Pomo West High School. This is from the coach. Said our girls lacrosse team is doing pretty well this season after losing so many seniors last season. We have a lot of opportunity to grow with so many young players on the team. Right now they're 3-4, hoping to make it 4-4 today with their game against Liberty High School. They all take on the role of being leaders on and off the field. They're always taking athletes that want to try the sport. So if there's anybody here that wants to try lacrosse, come on out. Coach is excited for the next couple of weeks, having the chance to make the playoffs again this season. Coaching staff said they're very proud of the group of girls, and we wish them the best of luck moving forward as well. Finally, can I please have representatives from boys lacrosse? Come on down. This is the same case. They're based out of Pomo West High School. It's a co-op team. We have 11 players, 11 boys from County High School playing on the team. And this is from the coach. Coach said that the season's had its fair share of up and downs, from practices being canceled due to weather, to buses being canceled due to snow in northern Colorado. But through it all, the team is getting better. A young team that is composed of 13 freshmen, 11 sophomores, 6 juniors, 3 seniors. And they are currently 3-1 in league and have a game this upcoming Friday. If you guys want to go check it out, starts JV's at 3, varsity begins at 5. Come to the game and support, and hopefully they get another win. Let's wish them the best of luck. Before I turn this over to Mr. Dilka, I just want to remind everybody, dance is tomorrow night at the Sangreta Cristo Arts Center from 8 to 11 p.m. The dance is a formal dress dance. Please make sure if you have a guest that does not attend County High School that you've turned in a guest dance pass by today. And please remember to have fun and be safe. Mr. Dilka?
Wow, Pueblo County High School, you know how to put on a show. Let's hear it for our staff for putting on this wonderful event for us today. Class folks, for student folks, and everybody in the department. To our court, you are a wonderful representation of Pueblo County High School. Your family should be commended. Another round of applause for our court. By what's on display today, there is something for everybody at Pueblo County High School. To our guests, visitors, families, future Hornets, I want to personally welcome you to the best high school in the state of Colorado. As it's been said before, prom is a very memorable time for our students. It is important to make good decisions and be safe. Everyone is loved, everyone is cared for, everyone is valued. Make good decisions, please, okay? All right, with that being said, it's time to, before we do that, we want to honor our families in court. Please make sure you join us for a reception in the commons area after the assembly. And now it is time to honor our senior class. Let's please clap out our seniors.